فؤادك الأيام فتى.
ولا أدري هل فيهم من يسجد لهم، لا أستبعد أن فيهم من يفعل ذلك، بل أخبرني من أثق به أنه رأى من يسجد على عتبات باب مشهد الولي الذي يقصده تعظيما له وعبادة ويقسمون بأسمائهم.
He said, I don't know. Are amongst them those who prostrate for them, do sujood? And he said, لا أستبعدوا. I don't find that very far-fetched. أن فيهم من يفعل ذلك, that amongst them there are those who do it, who do sujood for them. And he said, I won't be. Rather, بل أخبرني من أثق به. I was informed by somebody who I really trust. أنه رأى, that he saw من يسجد على عتبة باب مسجد الولي الذي يقصده. That he done sujood and prostrated in front of a door of a shrine that he went to, came to. Why? تعظيم الله, because he was honoring the wali here in the grave, in the shrine. وعبادة, and in terms of honoring him and worship him. ويقسمون بأسمائهم, and they swear by the names of those so-called awliya. إن الله وإن إلى رجوع.
بل إذا حلف من عليه حق بسم الله تعالى لم يقبلوا منه.
If a person swears, إذا حلف من عليه حق بسم الله تعالى, swears by Allah's name, say something by Allah's name, they won't trust him, they won't accept it from him.
فإذا حلف باسم ولي من أوليائهم قبلوه وصدقوه.
But if he swears by the name of a wali from the awliya, they will accept that from him, they will trust him.
وهكذا كان عباد الأصنام.
And that's how the idol worshippers used to be.
وإذا ذكر الله وحده اشمأزت قلوب الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة. وإذا ذكر الذين من دونه إذا هم يستبشرون.
That these people, إذا ذكر الله, if Allah is mentioned, وحده alone, if Allah, but Allah, the only one who deserves to be worshipped, when he said, إشمأزت قلوب الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة. ما معنى إشمأزت؟ إشمأزت means أن يكرهون وينفرون. Their hearts run away and dislike, show enmity and hate. أشد الكراهة. They excessively hate to be mentioned, Allah alone to be mentioned. That's the way only. Ha. وإذا ذكر الذين من دونه إذا هم يستبشرون. But if besides Allah is mentioned from the Asnam, from the Andad, from the Awliyas, you know, if they are mentioned, إذا هم يستبشرون, they become what? فرحاً بذكر معبوداتهم. They become very happy that the things that they worship are being mentioned. They start becoming excited and happy. نعم.
وفي الحديث الصحيح.
من the hadith which is sahih is Bukhari and Muslim. من حديث عبد الله بن عمر. The hadith is sahih, meaning it's in Bukhari and Muslim, من حديث عبد الله بن عمر.
من كان حالفاً فليحلف بالله أو ليصمت.
Anyone who's going to make an oath, wallahi, anyone's going to say a vow, an oath, he should say it with Allah's name. Or if not, أو ليصمت, or be quiet. Don't say anything.
وسمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجلا يحلف باللات فأمره أن يقول لا إله إلا الله.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم heard a man swearing by Lat, and the messenger commanded him to say La ilaha illallah. Bukhari and Muslim narrated the hadith from the hadith of Abu Hurairah.
وهذا يدل على أنه ارتد بالحلف بالصنم فأمره أن يجدد إسلامه.
وهذا يدل, and this indicates أنه ارتد, that he apostated. بالحلف بالصنم. The Shaykh shouldn't use the word صنم. He should have said ارتد بالحلف بغير الله, besides Allah, because it'd be more comprehensive and it more general. نعم. So the Prophet ﷺ, فأمره أن يجدد إسلامه. So the Prophet ordered him to revive and renew his Islam.
فإنه قد كفر بذلك.
Because he became a kafir with this.
كما قررناه في سبل السلام شرح بلوغ المرام.
As we have elaborated and spoke about this issue in the book سبل السلام, which is شرح بلوغ المرام, and it's a book which he رحمه الله wrote. It's a book of his which he explained Bulugh al-Maram. Subul al-Salam, which is a sharh of Bulugh al-Maram. Bulugh al-Maram by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. He made a sharh on it. Naam.
وَمِنْحَةُ
الْغَفَّارِ is another one he authored, رحمه الله تعالى.
فَإِنْ قُلْتَ لَا سَوَى لِأَنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ قَدَ قَالُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَقَدَ قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَقَاتِلَ النَّاسِ
أَنْ أُقَاتِلَ النَّاسَ
حَتَّى يَقُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ فَإِذَا قَالُوهَا عَصَمُوا مِنِّي دِمَاءَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ إِلَّا بِحَقِّهَا
فَإِنْ قُلْتَ If you say to me, لَا سَوَى These are not the same. These people are not the same you're talking about. And these grave worshippers, they're not the same. How? لأن هؤلاء قد قالوا لا إله إلا الله because these people said لا إله إلا الله and the مشركين قريش they refused to say لا إله إلا الله and the messenger said أمرت I was ordered أن أقاتل الناس حتى يقولوا لا إله إلا الله I was ordered to fight with the people until they say لا إله إلا الله فإذا قالوها if they say it عصموا مني دماءهم وأموالهم إلا بحقها their blood their wealth it becomes sacred for me meaning I'm not allowed to touch it I hope
وقال لأسامة ابن زيد
وقال لأسامة ابن زيد
قتلته بعدما قال لا إله إلا الله
and the hadith of أسامة ابن زيد حديث أسامة ابن زيد where he said قتلته you killed him بعدما قال لا إله الله after he said لا إله الله again it's the argument that they're bringing forward which is that these people say لا إله الله and you can see the prophet saying that when a person says لا إله الله their blood is secreted from you And the Prophet ﷺ is saying to you, when Usama ibn Zayd, the man said, La ilaha illallah, the Prophet said to him, Did you kill him after he said, La ilaha illallah? Naam.
وَهَؤُلَاءِ يُصَلُّونَ وَيَصُومُونَ وَيُزَكُّونَ
وَيَحُجُّونَ
بِخِلَافِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ
And these people are praying, they're fasting, they give charity and zakat. They do Hajj different to the mushrikeen. They're opposite to the mushrikeen. How can you compare them to the mushrikeen? The Sheikh said, I will say them. Reply to your question.
قَدْ قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِلَّا بِحَقِّهَا
Because the messenger said, in that hadith that you guys brought, أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أُقَاتِلَ النَّاسَ حَتَّى يَقُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ فَإِنْ قَالُوهَا عَصَمُوا مِنِّي دِمَاءَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ إِلَّا بِحَقِّهَا وَحِسَابُهُمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى إلا بحقها underline that word إلا بحقها means what? إلا بحقها means except with its rights لا إله إلا الله's rights and what are لا إله إلا الله's rights? هيا
وحقها
its right is
إفراد الإلهية والعبودية لله تعالى
so the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم when he said I was ordered to kill and fight against the people until they say لا إله إلا الله and anyone who says it his blood is sacred from me or safe from me and his wealth is safe from me if he comes with its rights إلا بحقها so the sheikh is now telling you what is the haq means إفراد الإلهية he singles Allah in worship والعبودية لله تعالى نعم that's the right of the حقها so just saying it isn't what the hadith said the hadith says إلا بحقها نعم
والقبوريون لم يفردوا هذه العبادة
and the grave worshippers they haven't singled Allah in this worship in his worship
فلم تنفعهم كلمة الشهادة.
So it hasn't benefited them, the utterance of the shahada. It doesn't benefit them.
فإنها لا تنفع إلا مع التزام.
إلا مع الالتزام. التزام. مع الالتزام.
مع التزام.
فإنها لا تنفع. The word doesn't benefit you unless there's an التزام. Meaning you what? You have come with what it necessitates. You stick by the word. نعم.
كما لم ينفع اليهود يهود قولها
كما لم ينفع اليهود قولها
ينفع اليهود قولها
just like the Jews it didn't benefit them their statement
لإنكارهم بعض الأنبياء.
Because they rejected some of the prophets.
وكذلك من جعل غير من أرسله الله نبيا.
And the same is like what? Anybody who makes, who takes, غير من أرسله الله نبيا, who takes a person other than the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as a messenger.
لم تنفعه كلمة الشهادة.
The utterance of the shahada won't benefit you.
ألا ترى أن بني حنيفة كانوا يشهدون أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله يصلون ولكنهم قالوا إن مسيلمة إن مسيلمة نبي.
Do you not see أن بني حنيفة, بني حنيفة are the people of مسيلمة بن الكذاب who claimed he was a prophet and he got killed the day of Yarmouk. Khalid and the army, they destroyed him. The Bani Hanifa, they were testifying to La ilaha illallah. And they testified that Muhammad is his final messenger. Sorry, they testified that Muhammad is a messenger from Allah. But they also said that Musaylama is a Nabi. They also said that. Naam.
فقاتلهم الصحابة وسابوهم فكيف بمن يجعل للولي خاصة الإلهية ويناديه للمهمات
للملمات
للمهمات
للمهمات no problem. You see, ولكنهم قالوا, but they only said إن مسيلمة نبي, مسيلمة is a prophet. فقاتلهم الصحابة وسبوهم. The Sahabas fought against them and they took them as spoils of war, captives. That's what the Sahabas did. فكيف, how is the matter going to be then? بمن جعل للولي خاصة الإلهية. Somebody who doesn't, Musaylim was only given a prophet and the Sahabas fought with them as kufar. Imagine a person who gave not a prophethood to a person. He made him ilah. He gave him the rights of Allah. How is the matter going to be? للولي خاصة الإلهية. ويناديه للملمات. Times of hardship and times of problems, what do? They call on to him. So the Sheikh is trying to say, ليس مجرد النطق بشهادتين تنفع. The utterance of لا إله إلا الله by itself does not benefit. It's not نافعا. إذا ما أتى الإنسان بنواقضها. إذا ما أتى الإنسان بنواقضها. The person comes with that which nullifies it. He comes with that which goes against لا إله إلا الله. And he keeps telling you, I said لا إله إلا الله. إذا لا إله إلا الله is not مجرد كلمات يقال. It requires what? You have to come with its لوازم and its مقتضى. نعم.
وهذا أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب.
And here we have Ali ibn Abi Talib, another companion from the noble companions of the Messenger, عليه الصلاة والسلام.
حرق أصحاب عبد الله بن سبا.
He burnt the people of Abdullah ibn Sabah al-Yahudi. Abdullah ibn Sabah al-Yahudi, he was a man from Yemen. Aslan, he was from Yemen. He was a Hadrami. He came from Yemen. He came to, he opened Shubuhat amongst the mists of the Muslims. He used to say that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to come back, just like Isa ibn Maryam is going to come back. And he started to say to the people, who's more righteous? Who's more greater in the eyes of Allah, Isa ibn Maryam or Nabiullah Muhammad? The people said, Nabiullah Muhammad is the best. Then he said that if Muhammad is better, how is it possible that Isa ibn Maryam is going to come back and Nabiullah Muhammad won't come back? And then he brought this aqidah for the Shia called Aqidatul Raj'iyah, that Nabiullah Muhammad is going to come back. After a while, he started to push this ideology called, that in Ali ibn Abi Talib, which you guys can see, he's an ilah. Him and Allah, they emerged. Allah is inside Ali ibn Abi Talib. He pushed this view. The issue with Abdullah ibn Sabah was he wasn't one of those people who came out forward. When he said these things, he wouldn't say it out publicly. He would just say it in the midst of the Muslim, whisper it to them. And so Ali ibn Abi Talib, and then he brought other ideologies on the table, which is Ali ibn Abi Talib was the one elected by the Prophet. He was elected by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they say when he was a Yahudi before he claimed to be a Muslim, when he was a Yahudi, he used to also go extreme on Yusha ibn Nun. Yusha, he used to go extreme on him. Who was that? The fatah with Nabiullah Musa. Ala kulli hal, Abdullah ibn Sab' al-Yahudiyya has a group within the Rafidah and the Shia called Saba'iyya. There are firqah within the Shia called Firqah al-Saba'iyya. They ascribe back to who? Abdullah ibn Sab' al-Yahudi. You see? Now, Abdullah ibn Sab' al-Yahudi, when he brought these statements to the people, they started to believe in it. The general mass started to believe Ali ibn Abi Talib was what? Ilah. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, he burnt them alive, those who claimed it. Some of them didn't say it. Abdullah ibn Sabah, on the other hand, because no one was able to bring a witness against him, they couldn't prove it that he said it, they couldn't bring witnesses what they were saying, he was released. But what Ali did was, he got rid of him and he took him somewhere far from the people. The rest, Ali ibn Abi Talib, he burnt them alive. Now.
وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ
And those people Ali burnt alive were all saying what?
لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ
They were saying لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ
وَمُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ
And that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. They were all saying that.
وَلَكِنْ غَلَوْا فِي عَلِيٍّ رَضِيَ
اللَّهُ But they were extreme in the issue of Ali ibn Abi Talib. They went too far with him. On too extreme with him. Now the issue of burning somebody alive, Ali ibn Abi Talib, the ruling didn't reach him. He didn't know. Huh? But when it reached him, what Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Abdullah ibn Abbas said, أَمَا لَوْ كُنْتُ مَكَانَهُ If I was in the position of Ali, مَا فَعَلْتُ فِعْلَهُ I would not have done what he did. Because I heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, لَا يُعَذِّبُ بِالنَّارِ إِلَّا رَبُّ النَّارِ No one burns with the fire except the Lord of the fire. That's Allah's rights. You see? So Ali ibn Abi Talib, he burnt them because he didn't know the ruling. He didn't know the ruling in this issue. And when he heard, Ali ibn Abi Talib realized that what the ruling was that. Now,
وَاَعْتَقَدُوا فِيهِ مَا يَعْتَقَدُ الْقُبُورِيُّونَ وَأَشْبَاهُهُمْ
These people, this group, the Shia, they went extreme onto Ali ibn Abi Talib. Extreme onto him until they said he's an ilah, la shak. And there's still a group that still believes that today. There is a group right now who believe Ali ibn Abi Talib is an ilah. And it is Bashar Asad alayhi min Allah ma yastahiq. May Allah give him what he deserves. And his father, alayhi min Allah ma yastahiq. Hafiz al-Asad, Bashar's father, may Allah give him also what he deserves. They believe what? That Ali ibn Abi Talib is ilah. That they believe Ali ibn Abi Talib is ilah. Walidhalika, it's amazing and it's funny because Iran, who are Rafida, I mean they're called Imamiyya, or they're called Ithna Ashariya. They have those names. Rafida, Imamiyya, Ithna Ashariya. They're all those names, Iran. Iran, who are Rafida, see Bashar's ideology, which is the Nusayriya. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said in the Kitab Minhaj Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah, Hum akfaru min al-Yahudi wal-Nasara. That the Nusayriya are more kuffar than the Jews and the Christians. The Jews and the Christians are more close to Islam than the Nusayriya. You see, Iran believes that Bashar is a kafir. But why are they funding him? Why are they aiding him right now when you look at what's taking place? هكذا. This is how their way is. They have a common enemy. They have a what? The Sunnis are a common enemies of theirs. So right now, let's agree to what? This ideology which so many people try to push today, which is let's agree to disagree. Even though we're not together, in terms of ideology, we have a common enemy, let's work towards that. Mm-hmm. So, Ali ibn Abi Talib, when they went extreme on him,
بَلْ عَاقَبَهُمْ عُقُوبَةً لَمْ يُعَاقِبْ بِهَا أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعُصَادِ
Ali, so he said, they went extreme on Ali ibn Abi Talib, and they started to believe about Ali, what our grave worshippers today believe about their awliya. So what did he do? فَعَاقَبَهُمْ عُقُوبَةً لَمْ يُعَاقِبْ بِهَا أَحَدٌ مِنَ الْعُصَادِ Ali dealt with them and he punished them in a way where he never ever punished a person who sinned. The way he dealt with them.
فَإِنَّهُ حَفَرَ لَهُمُ الْحَفَائِرَ
He dug holes for them. He said, dig holes for me.
وَأَجَّجَ لَهُمْ نَارٌ وَأَلْقَاهُمْ فِيهَا
And he burnt a fire and he threw them in it.
وَقَالَ
And Ali ibn Abi Talib said,
لما رأيت الأمر أمرا منكرا أججت ناري ودعوت قنبرا.
He said, when I saw, لما رأيت الأمر أمرا منكرا, when I saw that the matter was evil, when I saw how bad the matter was, أججت ناري, I started to burn the fire, ودعوت قنبرا, and I called unto قنبر. قنبر, some Ibn Hajar rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions that Qanbar, he was a poet for Ali ibn Abi Talib. And some say he was the man who lit the fire for him. This story, Hafidh ibn Hajar mentions that the qissa of the tahriq, Ali of the Saba'iyya, he said, Hafidh ibn Hajar rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, وَهَذَا إِسْنَادٌ حَسَنٌ. The chain of narration is authentic. The chain of narration is what? Is authentic. Sometimes they say, لَمَّا رَأَيْتُ أَمْرًا أَمْرًا وَلَمَّا رَأَيْتُ الْأَمْرَ أَمْرًا مُنْكَرًا. أَجَجْتُ نَارِي وَدَعُوتُ قَنْبَرًا. And sometimes they say in a different format, which is the next lines of poetry.
وَقَالَ الشَّاعِرُ فِي عَصْرِهِ لِتَرْمِي بِالْمَنِيَّةُ حَيْثُ شَاءَتْ إِذَا لَمْ تَرْمِي بِي فِي الْحُفْرَتَيْنِ إِذَا مَا أَجَّجُوا فِيهِنَّ نَارًا رَأَيْتُ الْمَوْتَ نَقْدًا غَيْرَ الدَّيْنِ.
He's describing the day of what took place because he was there. So when Ali ibn Abi Talib burnt, he lit the fire and they were burning inside it. He's describing it. نعم. والقصة فيه.
والقصة في فتح الباري وغيره من كتب الحديث والسير.
نعم. So this story is present in what? In the books of what? Like فتح الباري. فتح الباري is what? It's the sharh of what? Sahih al-Bukhari. And it's Ibn Hajar's one, not Ibn Rajab's one. Ibn Rajab also has a Fath al-Bari. But here he's talking about the Fath al-Bari written by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. And it's also written in other books of, not just in that book, but it's also written elsewhere. Na'am.